Let's say we all have a normal life. We are educated, we have a job, a bunch of friends, and once or twice a year we go on vacation. But once a while on a Sunday night, we lie in our bed, and just before we fall asleep, how many of you sometimes think, "Oh, damn, I don't want to work tomorrow." And once in a while on a Sunday night, we lie in our bed, and we ask ourselves, "That's all? Is that really everything? Come on, there must be more in life for me." How many of you had those thoughts before? Thank you. And how many of you want to learn some tools how to actually get or to reach that more in life? All right, thank you very much. My topic today is how to live life to the fullest by simply adopting some really easy mindset skills, which, by the way, are going to have a huge impact on your personal life. I feel really honored to have this opportunity to talk in front of you today, so thank you so much for it. In the next couple of minutes, we are going to figure out how some really easy mind shifts can transform everybody's life. Those life hacks used in the correct way can turn everybody's life into a 24/7 party all year long. It can boost your business, your income, it helps you to get shit done, and it can also shift your relationship with your loved ones onto the next level. I'm 31 years old, and for the past 7 years, I've traveled around the world. I spent most of my 20s exploring close to 70 countries. On my trips, I came in contact with a variety of people from all over the world. These people had different backgrounds, religions, grew up in different circumstances, and they all had their personal story in life. Traveling is also the reason how I got to know my girlfriend, and for the past 4 years, we've traveled together on this beautiful and mesmerizing planet. But before all of that, I was a different person, and therefore I want to tell you a story. Yeah, you can actually laugh, but this is me back in 2009. I had a normal life, I had a job, I sold business software, I worked 9 to 5, my income was okay, and I had an own business car, an Audi A3 Sportsback. Big rims, very fast, and a cool sound system. Back then, I was pretty materialistic, and I had a shiny career ahead of me. But then, in March 2009, something happened. I went on my annual leave, and I flew to New Zealand, to the other side of the world. And back in Europe, which is in March, the peak season of being winter depressed. And you know, you walk along the streets and it's gray and it's rainy and it's cold and, you know, people just walk around like zombies. They're afraid to show you the teeth and you actually have to turn them around to make them smile. But I was in New Zealand on the other side of the world. It was summer, it was 25 degrees. And on my first day, I rented a camper and I drove along the coast and I came across a beautiful beach and I thought, hey, I want to stay there for the night. So I pulled over, and I opened up the trunk, put down 2 chairs, 1 table, a bottle of red wine, and I eventually started to prepare my dinner. And then a couple of other backpackers joined me, and we had this really amazing and cozy, beautiful get-together right on the shoreline, sitting in front of a bonfire. And when you travel, there's always, always this one guy who's able to play Wonderwall from Oasis on a guitar. It's always like that. And when I went to bed, something crazy happened. While I was lying on the back of my camper van, I fell asleep to the sound of the ocean. I had this huge smile on my face. And I was just happy. I just lived in that moment. And the next morning, something even more crazy happened. I woke up and I still had this smile on my face. And this went on for 3 weeks, the whole time I was in New Zealand. And it was just amazing. Like all the people I met, all the experience, all the adventures I lived through. It was, or even like the landscape in New Zealand, it was just breathtaking. When I got back home, something changed. I could actually see my life lying down in front of me, like on railways. You know, if I go along, you can see more money coming in, bigger promotions, bigger cars. And I asked myself, "That's all? Is that really everything? Come on, there must be more in life for me." And I started to get scared of that thought of being 60 or 70 years old and looking back on my life, and the only thing I've done was chasing digital numbers on my bank account. And I started to realize there's so much more out there, so much more to explore, so much more than just work 9 to 5. So I decided to change my life. When I decided to quit my job, the feedback of my social environment was not as positive as you might think. There was nobody waiting around the corner telling me, you know, Nick, oh my God, this is awesome, congratulations, to give me a high five. No, people judged me. People asked me, are you stupid? You're throwing away your career, your safe job. You should take care about your retirement plan. But instead, you just walk away from your responsibilities just to travel. I had a lot of doubts about my decision. I was scared. I actually got poisoned by the fear and thoughts of others. Today, when I look back, and I can say that with 100% guarantee, to change my old life, it was the best decision I ever made. And this is why I'm here today, to show you how important it is to listen to your own heart, to live life to the fullest, on your full potential, and eventually create a life you always dreamt of. By simply adopting the following attitudes I got taught during my adventures around the world. When people ask me, how do I finance my travels? And I got this question asked a lot. I used to answer, oh, well, I don't have to take care about money because I got really rich parents. And that was the exact same reaction all the time. 1% was like smiling or laughing, and 99% were sitting there and probably thought, what an idiot. But the truth is, I don't have rich parents. I finance it by myself. But the most important thing is you need to feel that burning desire. You need to be convinced that it's going to work out just fine in the end. The most important thing to achieve your goal is the right mindset to it in the first place. When your energy flows on a certain level, out of nowhere, suddenly, there will be new opportunities. You're going to meet new people. You change your priorities. It's called the law of attraction. When I decided to travel the world, I didn't have enough money to do so, but I was working 9 to 5, and I actually got changed in the toilet of my office in a bartending outfit to go and do bartending jobs until 2 a.m. in the morning. Or when I was in Australia and I got dropped and I had $40 left in my account. But my dream was still so big to continue to travel, so I found myself 5 jobs at the same time. I worked 16 hours a day, 7 days a week, for 3 months straight. And yes, it was busy. And yes, it was stressful. But it didn't feel like that. Actually, it just felt like another step closer to continue to travel, to continue to pursue my dream. So this is why it's so important in the first place. It's all about the mindset. When I went to Mexico, my Spanish skills were pretty limited. I could tell a girl that she has beautiful eyes, and I could order a beer. That's it. I know a couple of you might think, oh, well, that should be enough. But I really wanted to dig in deep, so I signed up for a language course, and I had this amazing opportunity to stay with a guest family. And my guest mom, Juanita, she was such a lovely woman. And after 3 days, I thought my Spanish skills improved big time. So after school, we sat down, we had lunch together, me and my guest mom, and we ate a delicious soup. And then I started to talk to her in Spanish. And I told her, you know, about my family back home, about my passion for cooking. And then I told her that I actually already got better cooking skills than my mom. And then she stood off, and she was kind of pissed off. And she walked to her room, and she slammed the door, and I was sitting in front of my soup, and I had no clue what was going on. The next day, when I explained this whole situation to my teacher, she actually cried because of laughing so much. And then we figured out that the day before, I hadn't had told Juanita that my cooking skills were better than my mom's. I actually told her right in her face, Juanita, my cooking skills are better than your mom's. Since that moment, I know that Mexicans doesn't like your mama jokes. But don't be afraid of making mistakes. Learn from them, gain experience. Making a mistake out of a lack of knowledge is as normal as learning to walk. If you fall down, just get up and try again. Making mistakes is the greatest source of knowledge you will ever have, followed by Google. But if I would be scared to make mistakes learning a new language, I couldn't be bothered to talk at all because I was making mistakes in every single sentence. But because I learned from them, after 6 weeks, I was almost able to have just about a normal conversation with people from Argentina, with people I could never ever talk to before in my entire life. Don't be afraid of making mistakes. Traveling is not just about surfing, soaking up the sun, drinking mojito in your board shorts at the beach. I spent a lot of time on my own while I was traveling, and I worried, I thought about everything, about my life, what I wanted to pursue, and I started to compare myself. I started to compare myself with people who were further than me, who were more successful, who seemed to figure out their whole perfect life. But to be honest, everybody has to walk their own path in life. Sometimes you're ahead, sometimes you're behind, and the race is long. And in the end, it's only with yourself. So don't compare yourself. Take people as an inspiration, as an example. Learn from their mistakes, but don't compare yourself. You have to walk your own path. If you do so, something extraordinary is going to happen. In the end, you don't see yourself in a big competition anymore. You're actually going to be happy for people when they achieve something. You don't stress yourself too much anymore. You actually use your energy to get ahead in your own life with your own speed instead of worrying or being envious about others. We all have at least two things in common here. Number one is we all have dreams and goals. It doesn't matter if they're personal or business related. And the second thing is we all had at least this one situation where we did not make this one necessary step to get ahead to pursue our dreams out of fear. The fear of what other people might think about it. How many of you in this room deeply, really deeply care about my personal dreams and goals? You see? Oh, you do? Thank you. I appreciate it. No, but the truth is, nobody gives a shit. In a certain way, we're all selfish. When it comes to our own dreams and goals, we just care about ourselves. Yes, maybe people have an opinion about it or trash talk about it for a minute. But in the end, nobody gives a shit. So if you want to travel the world, or if you want to create a business, or if you want to improve your skills or whatsoever, go for it. Don't be afraid of what other people might think about it. When I traveled in the States, I met this one girl from Eastern Europe, and her dream was to become a professional photographer. And to do so back home in her own home country, there were no opportunities to do so. So she went to the States, and she offered herself as an unpaid trainee to gain experience in the photo sector. And during nights, she worked night shifts as a waitress to make some money to afford some other course to attend. And all her friends, they thought, oh, she's going to be crazy, that her idea were nuts, that she's going to fail. But this girl, she just did not give a shit about other opinions. And today, you can actually see herself, or you can see her photos covering magazines and commercials all over the world. So don't be afraid to pursue your dreams because of the fear what other people might think about it. Embrace yourself. Get to know yourself, and finally, fall in love with yourself. It has nothing to do with being conceited or cocky, and you actually don't have to wear a cape to be your own superhero, because your superpower is to be responsible. When I decided to travel the world, I took that responsibility because I learned I'm the only one who is in charge for it. So, all those, like, sometimes, like in the first place, I was quite scared of taking that responsibility because I could not blame anybody else anymore for anything in my life. And actually, we are really good in blaming others. We use them as an excuse to not go out of our comfort zone. But after a while, it felt like a relief because I got to choose who's going to be the captain of my own lifeboat. And it was me. So all those attitudes combined, we just heard, combined, is going to lead to this, to be your own superhero, to take that responsibility. And finally, there's one more really important lesson I learned. I mean, I went through some really crazy shit the past couple of years. If it was having a fear of death experience while I was sailing on a catamaran through a hurricane, or when I was standing on a beach in Fiji and somebody actually shot me with a spear gun through my thumb in my chest by accident, or when I got dropped, or I could see myself in places where I had no place to sleep. But to be honest, I don't want to miss out a single experience out of those, because those situations taught me the most important lesson. To be grateful. To not take anything for granted, to appreciate all the small things in life, to sit here, to listen, to read. In the beginning, I said we all have a normal life, like to be educated, to have a job, to have a bunch of friends, to go on vacation once or twice a year. This is not a normal life. We all live an extraordinary life. We are so privileged. We have shelter, we have food, we have water, we have peace. But all those impressions, all those learnings, all those experiences and adventures during my trips taught me so much about the true value of life. Life is not there just to chase digital numbers on your bank account. Life is there to be lived to the fullest with your own true potential and a smile on your face. So the next time you're gonna lie down in your bed on a Sunday night and you think, is that really everything? Deep inside, you already know the answer. Just listen to your heart and go get it. Thank you very much.